Hello everybody, I hope you all are fine now at home. Now today we are going to do multiplication and this is for standard 5. So I have taken one number over here, 24 multiplied by 4. Now the number to be multiplied, that is 24, is called what? Multiplicand. And the number by which we multiply, that is 4, is called what? Multiplier. And after multiplication, the result which we get is called product. So these are three parts of multiplication: multiplicand, multiplier, and the result is called product. Now take one small example over here. 275 multiplied by 300. If zeros are there at the last, don't multiply, leave like that. Take the number 275 multiplied by 3. So I have multiplied over here. 275 multiplied by 3, we get 825. So I got the answer 825, and two zeros are there, you put two zeros. So after multiplying 275 multiplied by 300, the result is, or the product is, 82500. Now we have got, I have taken another example over here, 1520 multiplied by 2785. So first you take this number and multiply by this 1520. So 5 zeros are 0, 5 2s are 10, 1 in hand, 5 5s are 25, and 1 26, 2 in hand, 5 1s are 5, 6 7. So after multiplying by 5, I got this. Next line, you put a cross over here and then multiply by 8. After multiplying by 8, I got the answer over here, 0 6 1 2 1. Then again cross. Then second place also cross. Now take 7 and multiply by 1520. I got the answer 10640. Now again put the cross here, first number, second number, third number, and then we multiply by 2. 1520 multiply by 2, I got 3040. After that we add 0 0 6 6 12, 1 in hand, 7, 8, 9, 9 plus 4, 13, 1 in hand, then 6 plus 4, 10, 2, 12, and 1, 13, 3, 1 in hand, 1, 1, 2, and 3 and 1, 4. This is how we multiply the number. Remember where to put the cross. From second number, then first place cross. Then third number, second place cross. The fourth number, third place cross. And then we add. Now, exercise 4.2, we'll discuss some problem sums. Now, see number 1. The cost of school bag is rupees 785. What is the cost of 350 such bags? Remember that. How to understand a sum is on multiplication. When the value of 1 is given and you're finding the value of many, then we have to multiply. See over here, the cost of a means one school bag is 785. What is the cost of 350? Means you are finding many, then you have to multiply. Now, one example I have done for you, the same sum, number 1. See, cost of a school bag is rupees 785. Therefore, cost of 350 such school bags. So we multiply over here, 785 multiply by 350. So 785 multiply by zeros, I get zeros. Then multiply by 5, I got 3925. Then 785 multiply by 3, I got 2355. After multiplying, you add 0, 5, 7, 9 plus 5, 14, 4, 1 in hand, 336 and 1, 7 and 2. So cost of 350 school bags will be this way, 2,74,750. Now, question number 3. A factory produces 12,750 bottles of mineral water in a day. How many bottles will be produced in a year? So, in a day, so many bottles are produced. So, in 1 year, how many? So, in 1 year, we have how many days? 365 days. So this number should be multiplied by 365. Next, we come to number 7. A carton holds 25 packets of biscuits. Each biscuit packet has 20 biscuits. How many biscuits can be packed in 75 cartons? Yes, now this is the solution of sum number 7. So in a carton, how many packets we have? 25 packets. And in one packet, we have 20 biscuits. So first we will find total number of biscuits in one carton. That is 25 packets. And in one packet, we have 20 biscuits. So we multiply here, we get 500 biscuits in one carton. Now the question asked over here, how many biscuits will be there in 75 cartons? So 75 multiply by 500, because in one packet we have 500 biscuits. So in 75 packets, how many biscuits will have? 75 multiply by 500, that is 37500 biscuits, means 37,500 biscuits. Now we come to sum number 8. The monthly salary of Mr. Nair is rupees 30,725. What is his annual income? So in 1 month he earns so much. So in annual income means in 1 year, how much does he earn? So in 1 year we have how many months? 12 months. So this number should be multiplied by 12 and you will get his annual income. Now exercise 4.1, you do all these sums in your copies, that is number 2, number C and F, then number 3, B and E, and number 4, B and E, you do in your copy from exercise 4.2. The sums which I explained just now, that is number 1, 3, 7 and 8, which statements you do in your copy. I hope you understood this chapter. If you have any doubts, then when the school reopens, I'll clear all your doubts. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.